What we're working on is the indoor air quality project, looking at all our connected purifiers, and we're analysing that data on a global scale.
Air pollution is really anything that's carried in the air that has the potential to cause us harm. In an outdoor setting, it can be fine dust generated by traffic, wildfires, or pollen, but indoor air pollution, that's much more complicated and nuanced. It can be using cleaning solvents, combustion of fuels for cooking or heating, allergens and pet dander. We're quite fortunate over the past few years to have built up a network of over 5 million connected air purifiers, and we're hoping to use that data to really step change the awareness of air quality globally.
We capture, first of all, PM2.5. They're much smaller than a hair. These are ultra-fine particles that you can usually not see with your bare eyes. The majority of the countries that we study are seeing higher levels of indoor PM2.5 levels than outdoor levels for at least 6 months in a year. There are some countries that are exceeding the long-term WHO guideline for PM2.5 every month in that year. As you can see, winter is the most polluted season in countries that experience temperate seasons. What we're seeing is that the PM2.5 level peaks at around the evening. From our side, we collect this data and we use it to inform decisions on how we improve our range of technologies.
We capture a range of pollutants in the home. We capture particulates, gases, as well as the formaldehyde. Connected data has allowed us to understand that the worst air pollution can often be at night, when many of our owners don't have their products on. The auto mode on the product allows the owners to leave their product on, and the machine does all the work, sensing, capturing, and destroying air pollutants in real time. Through the app, you could look individually at the pollutants it's capturing.
I think, sadly, when it comes to air quality, we are too reliant on our senses. Now, there can be real serious air quality problems in your indoor settings. Just because you can't see them doesn't mean they're not there. So we really want to make sure people are aware of the problem of indoor air quality so they can make healthier choices about how they live their lives.